During the Buddha's time, there was a young man who was distraught at the death of his father. The young man would go about town lamenting and unable to overcome his grief. During the Buddha's meditation, he sent out his divine eye to search for beings who would benefit from his help. The Buddha perceived that this man had the capacity to become a sotapanna, a stream enterer. The Buddha then went for alms in Sawati and came across the man's house. The Buddha waited patiently for the man to notice him. Even through his grief, the man was able to see that the Buddha was no typical monk. The man invited the Buddha inside for alms. The Buddha sat on the prepared seat, and the young man sat before him. The Buddha asked,
"Young man, are you grieving?"
The young man said,
"Yes, holy sir, I am."
The Buddha then said,
"In the past, even after losing a father, when the wise heard the words of wisdom, they were able to stop grieving."
At the request of the young man, the Buddha told the story of the past. Once upon a time, when Brahmadatta was reigning in Benares, the Bodhisattva was born into a family of landowners. He was given the name Sujata. However, when he was still young, his grandfather died. His father took this especially hard and was filled with sorrow. His father had his grandfather's bones put in an earthen mound and covered the area with flowers. Every day, he would come to this place and lament. The father stopped caring about bathing and eating. He also stopped attending to his business. The young boy noticed this and reflected. "Ever since the death of my grandfather, my father has not been able to get over it. He has surrendered to his grief. I am sure that no one can reach him except for me. I must find a way to free him from his mental prison." One day, while walking around the gates of the town, the young boy came upon a recently deceased ox. The young boy brought fresh grass and water and began earnestly trying to feed the dead animal.
"Come on, Mr. Ox, have some grass and water. You will feel better and be back to normal."
People who walked by and saw this strange sight would say,
"Sujata, have you lost your mind? Why do you offer grass and water to a dead animal?"
Sujata would ignore them and continued to try to feed the dead ox.
"Mr. Ox, just a little bite, please? A little sip? You haven't eaten in so long. Surely you'd want a small bite."
The people rushed to Suchata's father and told them what they had seen. They said,
"Your son has lost his mind. He is trying to feed a dead ox."
Upon hearing this, Sujata's father rushed to his side and witnessed the strange sight. Sujata's father said,
"My dear boy Sujata, have you lost your mind? Why are you trying to feed a dead animal? Nothing you can say can raise an ox from the dead. You are acting foolishly."
"Ah, father, I believe this beast may come back to life again. He still has his head and 4 feet. I see you weeping over my grandfather's remains and wishing him back to life. Yet,
He doesn't even have a body anymore. My ox has a better chance than grandfather at coming back to life.
My dear Sujata, you are wise. I now see that all things that have life will eventually depart from this world. All things are impermanent. Nothing will last. Death is inevitable for all beings that have life. Only fools deny this truth, and I will be a fool no longer. I am lucky to have a son such as you.
At the end of this story, the young man released his attachment to his physical form and became a Sotapanna. The Buddha then concluded the story by saying, "In those days, I was the wise Sujata."
What did you learn from this story? We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.